Troy with 3 strikes in this game and 4 in the previous.
She's had 7 strikes in a row on lane 19.
Cheryl Daniels had a spare back in the 4th frame. She left a 4. Team leads by 2 pins, and she rings a 10.
And that was a good shot again, leaving the 10. She also looked as though she stuck a little at the line, but you could see the ball just coming up, and it looks flush, but the 6 pin going right around the 10. Cheryl switching to a shiny or harder surface ball, which will skid more at the 10, although it's hard to imagine that they need any more skid today.
We've seen a lot of that this week, however, that shinier ball for the right side strikes for right-handers.
Well, the left side of the lane hooks a little more than the right, and when you go after the 10, you've got to cross that left side of the lane, so the shiny ball takes care of any early hook that might happen crossing over that left side.
Incidentally, the tassels and bells on Jocelyn's shoes as she hits a strike, the 3rd, are just for decoration and to help her keep the rhythm if she's going good, and the bells sure did help her that time. We have only a 2-pin lead for Daniels and Jennings, and right now we're going to pause for a regional break. You're watching the Ladies Pro Bowlers Tour on Sports Channel.
It's Husky football. 6 exciting weekends packed with Division 1A college action. Tickets are on sale now. Call the Husky ticket office at 1-800-332-HOWL.
Apparently, David Munson, Torrey's son, was expecting a lot more striking from everybody. It's been a long day. Grandma's got him. He's nice and secure. And here's Robin. And Robin left open back in the 5th. A little bit lighter adjusted and leaves that 5-7 again.
Almost exactly the same shot as she threw on her last turn. The ball deflecting again, leaving the 5-7, not getting any other pins to work for her. And she's gonna get another shot at it. Gonna try to skid this ball off to the right. She's close.
Oh, she needed another coat of paint on the ball, because that's the 2nd open she's left. It didn't come back. She thought it worked.
It didn't come back at all. Robin's having a hard time to get her ball to drive on this condition.
A 16-pin deficit now for the Romeos, but Torrey's red hot. She has 7 consecutive strikes in 2 games. She's
Torrey
in the group. The 10 was chopped a little bit, but it just wouldn't fall.
Torrey again making a very good shot. Her ball just not turning quite hard enough right in front of the pocket. It looks good right there. It's coming back towards the pocket. She takes the 5 out, but the 6 pin just lays down, and it wanted to take out the 10, but not quite hard enough.
She goes cross lane to get, oh, she leaves that double open. That's the first double open we've had, and that really gives Daniels and Jennings some breathing room. They have 27-pin lead. Now, that was unexpected.
Well, they went and took a 27-pin lead while they sat on the bench. Torrey really pulled up on that ball at the foul line. I'm not sure if she stuck or she just pulled out of the shot, causing the ball to go to the left of the 10-pin.
And Cheryl Daniels, who makes her adjustments on timing.
A good shot by Cheryl in that same week 10.
Jocelyn still looks nervous. She's done a good job tonight, but she still got the first time television jitters. And Cheryl kept saying, don't worry, once you make that first throw, it'll all go away, but I don't think so.
No, I'm not sure right now. Jocelyn's a pretty, let's say, hyper type person anyways, and she's trying to keep those emotions under control. Cheryl having trouble at the foul line.
But does cover the spare.
She stayed with it though. She didn't pull her head out of the shot after she stuck, and the ball projected out to the right, and she did get the 10.
Interestingly, Jocelyn has mentioned that her palms have been sweaty during this event, same as Leala Wagner and several of the other players. She says she's never had that problem before.
It must be from all the high stakes in Vegas, huh?
Oh, pulling those slots. She gave some hand direction after she let go of it and gets another strike.
Well, if Jocelyn's nervous today, she's not showing it when she gets to the foul line because she makes another good shot. You can see her ball will come back towards the pocket in a good, strong strike. And I know Jocelyn's going to show us how we feel about this.
She has four strikes. Meanwhile, Robin leaves the nine. Robin Romeo. And at best that she and her sister Tori can get 189. They needed that early foundation strike desperately for any chance after leaving a 7 and 8 frame open. And at least gets a mark.
In all strong bowling essence, this match is really over right now. But of course, Tori, who's done very well this evening, is going to try and get three strikes. That would put the Romeos at 189. That would just need good count from Daniels and Jennings to win the match.
That 10 remains up there. Well, you know, the Romeo sisters had bowled regionally for 4 or 5 years, and finally they won a tournament out there. They usually would wind up in the top 5 or 10, but when they won, they said, that's all. You can't bowl together anymore, and that was how they do it at some of the regionals.
And now Tori has come out full-time on the national tour, and they are bowling together at Samstown.
This time, Tori covers her 10-10.
Tori, who had a good showing on tonight's show for her first time on television, it'll be a good experience when she does make her first telecast as a single.
She does finish very well with a 177, and all Jennings and Daniels need to do is get one pin.
I know Cheryl can do this. She's going to try to make a good shot. She's been right in the pocket most of the match. Another good shot, leaving the four pin.
So we're going to have the number one and two seeds going against each other for the title. It's all over now. Daniels and this young lady, Jocelyn Jennings, Super J. Attractive young woman. Players from the Midwest, Detroit and Chicago, beat the Californians in this match. And for the Romeo sisters, they did get a victory together in their first match against Mercantati and Chernilia.
Cheryl Daniels, Jocelyn Jennings look very strong. They're playing a good line to the pocket, and their balls are hitting strongly.
If you're going to hit the nose, that's the time to do it. A 205. So 205 to 177, Daniels and Jennings over Tori and Robin Romeo. And we'll have the championship match with Michelle Mullen and Donna Adamek against Jennings and Daniels. You're watching the Ladies Pro Bowlers Tour on Sports Channel.
If you like having your life well defined,
it's the right beer now.
If you think that beer made in the Rockies sounds better than beer made in cities,
it's the right beer now.
Because when the game's this close, you don't want to drop the ball. So send in the silver bullet, the one that won't slow you down.
Coors Light. Yeah, it's the right beer now.
I'm Bob Knoll. My official title is Head of Auto Testing for Consumer Reports Magazine. But I really work for you.
And there are over 200 people who work for you at Consumer Reports. We test and report on everything from toothpaste to TVs.
Right now is a good time to try Consumer Reports because you can get a free trial issue with no strings attached.
Here are the details.
Call now for your free trial issue of Consumer Reports, the magazine that gives you all the pros and cons of a product, including price. Call for your free trial issue now, then decide. When the bill arrives, pay it and get 11 more issues, 12 in all, including the annual buying guide issue, for just $18. Or write cancel on the bill and owe nothing. If you do subscribe, you'll also get two free gifts, the New Medicine Show, updated and revised, and the 1989 buying guide issue.
So put Consumer Reports to work for you. Call now.
Call now for Consumer Reports.
Call toll-free 1-800-841-0300. That's 1-800-841-0300.
The hammer hits harder. When the team is counting on you, only the best will do. And nail, bowling balls, and accessories sold at fine pro shops everywhere.
Tuesday on the Seoul Olympics Encore, baseball is the main attraction. Host Jimmy Cefalo captures the feeling Jim Abbott and Team USA gave millions as they relive the excitement of the 1988 Summer Games. You won't want to miss this edition of the Seoul Olympics Encore, Tuesday night at 8 o'clock Eastern, 5 Pacific on Sports Channel. This event may not be available in all areas. Check your TV listings for further details. Here's what happened in our first match. Mercatani and Cernelia over Drake and Wagner. Low scoring match.
Neither team really finding anything at all, carrying a few Brooklyns for the strikes they did. It was really a battle of survival.
The Italian connection continued to advance as they defeated Vicky Montgomery and hard luck Lori Nichols.
Lori again going Brooklyn, getting a few breaks, but partner Vicky had a little problem getting the head pin. Cernelia and Mercatani just staying clean, grinding it out, winning the match by only four pins.
Then the Romeo sisters came on with the first 200-plus match of the evening, defeating Cernelia and Mercatani.
The Romeos came out hot. Tori Romeo looked great. She threw the last four strikes on her turns, and they defeated Cernelia and Mercatani easily, 210-186.
However, the combination of Jocelyn Jennings and Cheryl Daniels proved too much for the Romeo sisters in that last match.
Although Jocelyn Jennings' first television appearance, she threw key strikes. They started the match off with a turkey, and with two opens late in the game by the Romeos, they were able to defeat them 205-177.
So now Michelle Mullen and Donna Adamek will have their first appearance of the night. And throughout this tournament, they were three after the first block and then one straight across. And a lot of the players were saying, these two did not bowl themselves. How so the rest of us did? They were so far ahead after that, they never looked back.
Well, Michelle Mullen led the individual scorers by about 270 pins. And that's a lot of games. I mean, that's a lot of pins for only 36 games.
She had the highest individual average of over 211. They had the best match play record of 13-5. The team average was the highest at over 207.
They really outbowled the field this week. And the match play record was 13-5 because no one else could really bowl the high games as they were.
Now they're discussing which lane they like better for each of them, and who will go first, and who will stand which lane, and they get the choice of forcing Daniels and Jennings to have to do what they want them to do, since they're higher seated.
Both players are very comfortable playing the inside line. Earlier in the week, the shot was very deep. It was right around the fourth arrow. The last couple days, it moved out closer to the second arrow, but they got their big lead the second day, and the shot was very deep. You've got two players teamed up on the same team that feel comfortable playing that deep, and they really took advantage.
And Michelle Mullen will go first, and she will bowl on lane 19. She's maturing as a player and constantly improving her concentration. High and gets a split to start everything off.
And she came right out, and you can see she's much further in on the lane than any other player has been so far. She went right between the third and fourth arrow, but the ball going high, cutting right through the nose.
She
She'll have to go after the 4-6-7. Very difficult.
Near impossible. She'll hope for a bounce out of the back into the lane.
They start with an open frame.
Michelle has never been out of the first position in a televised match. And Donna says she can't remember the last time she bowled.
Well, I'm sure Donna has been in the few times. I just don't think she remembered when it was, but I'm sure she's come out of the number one spot many times.
Now Cheryl Daniels leaves the 10. This is the college graduate team. Daniels and Jennings both went to college and did some regional bowling while there, however. They weren't on their college teams. I don't think the Lawrence Institute in Michigan had a bowling team, however.
No, the college bowling has really grown over the last few years, but when Cheryl and Jocelyn attended, not all the schools had the programs they have now.
Jocelyn went to Illinois Circle Campus in Chicago. She picks up that spare, and they go up by 11. And here is Jocelyn Jennings, who in her debut on television had an excellent game.
She threw excellent shots. She was right around the pocket, except for her split that she had a little problem converting the 310. But all the other shots were right there, solid in the pocket.
They've been consistent. And the 7 won't go. Oh, it goes. It goes. It defied physics that time. I thought it straightened up.
Well, we have three players tonight from the Chicago area, and you can see the inside line she's playing right here. And she's coming in light, and she gets a good kick, and it's going to go. And she's going to help this. She kicked it off. Yeah.
Donna was looking at it as she was picking up her ball. And here's her first throw, and she gets a stride. Donna Adamek, who wears that heavy brace on her right arm because of the bone chip, she still has the chips, but they don't bother her. That support really does help her arm.
Yeah, she says it's really helped support her, and she hasn't had any problems. Going back to what I was saying earlier, Michelle being from the Chicago area, Jocelyn from the Chicago area, Lori from the Chicago area, the shot's deep inside of the lane, and that was the prevalent shot in the Chicago area for many years. And these players are comfortable playing it, and that's why they've all done well this week.
Jackie Mullen cheering on her daughter with that strike, overcoming that open frame in the first frame.
And you can see the inside line that Michelle Mullen is playing. She crosses over, and it's a solid hit, and she gets good carry.
Cheryl Daniels trying for a turkey on her team. Or rather, I'm sorry, for a double. And I'm not going to say the 7 won't go because it went very late last time. Cheryl Daniels, one of the most powerful on the tour.
And you're going to see a power again on this shot. Watch the cup wrist in the backswing. Very difficult for most women to do that. Most women do wear a wristband. You can see Jocelyn and Cheryl do not. And look at how well she goes through it. Her hand just rotating right around and through that ball. And that's where she generates her power from. It's all in the wrist.
Her dad gave her start and some great, great lessons.
Jocelyn taking a deep breath, a little bit of time. She's a little pumped up on her last shot. Wants to make sure she's collected before she makes this shot.
She's had a couple of 300 games on the tour, at least in the regionals, and an 8-3 series and a ring in 10.
Another good shot. Just didn't get that 6-pin to do the work. Going up and around the 10-pin.
Back to even. Jocelyn has really kept her emotions under control. She said that did concern her throughout the tournament and here on television. And sometimes when you're concentrating on that too much, your game may suffer, but she's done well on both.
It may, and she can raise the spirit. Speaking of Chicago, Jocelyn was the 1987 Chicago Woman Bowler of the Year.
Well, you had, as a Chicagoan yourself, did some of that type of bowling. Did you ever match up against any of the players in the pre-tour days?
Well, I went out on tour right out of college, so I didn't do a lot of bowling competition in the Chicago area, but as what I grew up through the juniors on.
The lanes in Chicago were never easy.
No, they've always been tough.
Amick Brooklyn leaving the 6. They had their chance for a turkey.
See, Donna Style again, a shorter player, who uses a high backswing and generates a lot of power out of her legs. Right there, she's in great position. You can see that left arm is going to do a lot of work, and she's going to pull through there, and look at the power she gets.
So Donna Danek, the lady who collects Donald Ducks, that's her hobby.
She gets them from all over the country. She has them doing everything that anything would do, but she has a lot of Donald Ducks.
And Jackie Mullen, hoping her daughter can duplicate the strike she got in the third frame. It's a one-pin lead for Daniels and Jennings. And Michelle Mullen comes up on lane 19.
Michelle Mullen, another player with a strong wrist, and she gets it into this one.
Strong wrist. She's never worn a band except in the early days when she needed it for a security blanket. She keeps it stronger, and her left arm stays down. She's a very powerful lady.
She's built very powerfully, and you can see that wrist stays right behind and firm. She doesn't need a wrist device. And this ball hits strong.
And does her partner get concerned? She talks it all the way in.
Yeah, she's going to help. All right.
This is Cheryl Daniels' ball. Knocks over the five. The seven is still up. A lot of sevens have stayed up in these last couple of games.
Just not getting the good mix. It seemed that earlier in the week, it was easier to carry the light hit. But the last couple days, it's gotten really tough to carry the off hit. And it looks so tonight.
Even in the fifth frame. No opens for Daniels and Jennings.
Jennings seeing she'd come back and carry the 10 this time. She's been right in the pocket.
This is for the $60,000 national doubles title.
That's a good shot. And she rips that five out. Although Jocelyn's roll isn't that high, she gets a lot of rotation. And she goes through the ball very well.
Donna has a strike and a spare on lane 20. From Victorville, California.
And a strike for Donna.
But oh, what a strike. A lucky strike.
Well,
and
we've
she'll
seen
take
that
them.
Before.
You bet.
And in this tournament, the biggest thing is to just take advantage.
Don't forget, Sports Nightly will be coming up next. Keep you up to date on everything that's happened today in the world of sports. On Sports Channel America, and we're delighted you're with us on the LPVT Tour, on the summer tour. And now, Michelle, having a palm trouble. Everybody with the tough grip this week.
Yes, they've all been having trouble getting a good feel of the ball. No one's really certain why or what it is. But she's taking a little extra time.
Trying for the turkey, they won't get it. It's the 2-8.
She got that ball a little bit wide, it just wouldn't come back. Leaving the 2-8 spare, she's got to be careful to cover both pins. She's got to get the drive on the ball to carry through with the 8. Probably going to play this very direct. She does right in front of it. It's not going to carry through.
Chops off the front. The second open by Michelle Mullen. His major change in her game has been the rhythm and pacing, and it's helped her.
She said she's been trying to get the ball down a little earlier, therefore causing the ball to roll up sooner instead of breaking on the back.
So a four-pin lead for Daniels and Jennings, and Cheryl Daniels in the seventh frame, trying for a double with her partner.
It looks good.
Good ball. Good ball. They do get the double. And they go up by 14 pins.
And that was a beautiful shot by Cheryl Daniels in the seventh frame. She stays low with this shot, keeps her head right in it. She gets a lot on this ball. And the sixth pin, you can see, is going to trip out the 10. She knows it was a good shot.
With so much power, she creates that natural hook, and there's no way you can avoid it with the way she rolls that ball. Now Jocelyn Jennings. Head high, and she's fortunate no split as the 6 and 10 stay out.
She's a little upset with herself. She's made all good shots since that 3-10, and this shot, she just pulled it a little bit, and it went through the nose, narrowly avoiding the split.
Lost a little bit of count, but don't forget, Mullen and Adamek are coming off an open in the seventh.
They're going to be trailing by 12 with this conversion. So Donna and Michelle desperately needing a double. It's getting late in the match.
Donna wants to say hello to a friend of hers, a little gal named Tina, who's in the Special Olympics from Victorville, California, and who really, really follows the ladies' pro bowling tour.
It's good to say hi to your fans now and then.
You know, throughout the week, Donna's had a friend of hers lining her up from the back, and it's really helped her.
Well, it sometimes helps to have someone who's not at the foul line, which is the bowler, someone who can see other things. It's not that unusual. Many players have their father or their coach with them,
yeah,
and they'll help them out.
Leading the 2-5. She says she might be sliding a little more on the synthetic, which is better for her. She gets a longer ball, better release.
Sometimes a longer slide can keep you a little smoother and get the ball into a little earlier roll.
Dangerous, but she does get that 5 to go down.
She was very fortunate to avoid the chop on that spare. The ball wanting to break, but just getting back, taking out the 5.
Michelle Mullen in the ninth frame with her team down by 12 pins. She's trying to smooth out that snap release of hers, and she used to hit up on the ball, and it took her out of her game, and she's smoothing it out. 10 stays. It was a good ball, too, but a little fast.
It was a good shot, and she did, when she first came out, she did hit up on the ball. She got the ball out onto the lane a little bit and caused her to be a little bit inconsistent, and now that she's gotten the ball down into the lane a little smoother and gotten through the shot smoother, she's really had a lot of good success with her second place in the U.S. Open and now here today.
And she's another one who drilled a new hard, shiny ball for those right side spares, and she covered. So Mullen and Adamek can get a 203 maximum score, and they trail by 13 pins.
Daniels and Jennings going at a 206 pace.
If they stay clean.
And that's a good shot. Oh, she comes up light, and she just wasn't able to take out the 7. She's had 2 bad breaks just like that this match.
Interestingly, Jocelyn will have to finish up for the team of Jennings and Daniel.
Well, Jennings and Daniel, they again use the strategy of staying on the same lane. They were lined up last game, and they decided to stay on the lane, and it didn't really matter to them who started, who finished. They just wanted to stay on their lane.
Both teams with a spare in the ninth frame and a 12-pin lead in this final match for Daniel and Jennings.
A strike right here would pretty much lock out Donna Adamek.